Hi, I'm Jack. Welcome to my channel, Practical Programming with Dr. Su. In this video series, you will learn everything you need to get started with WGPU graphics programming in Rust. This is a step-by-step tutorial video series on Rust WGPU API. Here, I will show you how to use this graphics API to create beautiful 3D graphics objects. This is the first video of the step-by-step WGPU graphics programming. Here, I will give you a brief overview on the WGPU API and explain what you can do with it to build your 3D graphics applications on both native devices and the web. Right now, we will use WGPU version 0.12.0. Since this API is not finalized yet and it changes quite often, I will update it to a new version in future examples in this video series when the new version is available. In this way, we can stay current with the WGPU API. So what is the WGPU? WGPU is a Rust implementation of the WebGPU API, while WebGPU is a specification created by the GPU for the Web Community Group. It is a next-generation graphics API and a future web standard for graphics and compute. WGPU is written in Rust, so it's a pure Rust graphics API. It is a cross-platform API, so which works on Windows, Linux, and Mac operating systems. WGPU runs natively on various graphics APIs, including Vulkan, Metal, DirectX 12, DirectX 11, and OpenGLVS. It can also run on top of WebGPU with WebAssembly. So it will provide modern 3D graphics and computation capability with GPU acceleration. So why we use Rust compared to other programming languages? Rust has three benefits. The better memory safety due to its compiler, high performance speed due to its zero-cost abstraction, and easy concurrency due to its data ownership model that prevents data races. You can see from this figure that Rust performance speed is compatible with C and C++, but its safety is much better than C and C++. It is actually compatible with Haskell, which is believed to be the safest programming language. According to a recent Stack Overflow survey, Rust has been the most loved programming language for the last 5 years in a row. So that's why we use Rust for our GPU graphics programming here. In this tutorial on WGPU graphics programming, I suppose you should be familiar with Rust programming language and syntax, and the basic Rust programming experience, and familiar with the cargo Rust package manager. Here, we're not going into much detail on Rust syntax. If you are not comfortable with Rust, you should read some Rust tutorial materials before watching this video series. On hardware side, in order to run WGPU application on your local machine, your machine should install a modern graphics card, such as NVIDIA GeForce or AMD Radeon graphics card. These modern graphics cards should also have a modern graphics APIs. For Windows, for example, you should have DirectX 12, Vulkan, or Angle. For Linux and Android, you should have Vulkan, GLES 3, or Angle. For Mac OS and iOS system, you should have a Metal graphics API. In this video series, we will cover the following topics. First, WGPU basics, WGSL seed language, and render pipelines. We also saw how to create primitives and simple shapes, 3D transformations, model, view, and projection matrices, GPU buffer, uniform buffer objects, animation, and camera control. We also covered normal vector calculation and light model computation, the texture coordinates, and texture mapping, color model, color maps, and color interpolation. We were so how to create 3D shapes, wireframes, surfaces, and charts. We discussed how to implement 2D and 3D fractal images directly in a fragment shader. We also discussed compute shader and large particle systems. All the example projects presented in this video series are taken from my recently published book called Practical GPU Graphics with WGPU and Rust. This book provides depth and details on math background and WGPU programming. So please visit my website at drsuit.net.com for more information about this book. Next, I will show you some example graphics objects we are going to create in this video series. And you can see that WGPU allows you to create advanced 3D graphics objects with real-time animation in GPU, which are impossible to do in CPU. Here are some simple 3D shapes, including sphere, cylinder, cone, and torus. These cubes are created using instance approach, which allows you to draw more than one of the same object that is faster than drawing each object individually. Here are 3D wireframe examples. A wireframe model is a visual representation of a 3D object used in computer graphics. It is often used in cases where a high screen frame rate is required. Here are some of parametric 3D surface examples. They all look beautiful because they have both color map and lighting effects. Here are text map examples on 3D objects. Texture plays an important role in 3D graphics. The modern GPUs have support for imaging texture built in on the hardware level. Texture mapping on 3D objects provides a more interesting and realistic look. These examples demonstrate that you can do texture mapping on sphere, cylinder, and 3D surface. You can also use multiple textures on 3D objects. You can see here, each face of our 3D cube has a different image texture. Here are examples of domain coloring for functions with complex variables. These beautiful pictures are drawn pixel by pixel based on bitmap rendering, which is a computation-intensive process. Here we perform all calculations and rendering directly in GPU, which makes possible for our real-time animation here. This is impossible in CPU. These are 3D fractal examples. They provide more structures than 2D fractals. Again, these nice pictures can be only created in GPU. In CPU, it is too slow and impossible to have this real-time animation. Here are some examples for large particle systems. This is a compute balls, and we try to simulate the flocking behavior of balls. This picture shows particle kinematics with collision to the wall. This shows three mass centers that attract particles. Here we use compute shader to perform physics-related computations and update the positions and velocities on each frame. This is only possible in GPU for simulating these large particle system in real time. If you want to learn how to create these pictures and particle systems, please stay tuned to this video series. Please also visit my website at drsu.net.com and my YouTube channel at Practical Programming with Dr. Su. Thank you for watching.